Hello, my beautiful beings. This reading is for Capricorn. We're gonna jump right on into it, so let's see what you guys got going on. Excuse me. All right, so my Capricorn, so we're going to talk about your past, your present, and your future, okay? And your overall reading of the energy is great. I mean, you're cutting off things that no longer serve you. You're not just standing for anything. You're dropping everything. Like, if it don't serve you, you are cutting it out of your life, period, point blank. What life wants you to know right now, it says that you are giving away your power. You are a badass, so act like it, okay? Okay, Capricorn. So in your past, I see that you feel like there's someone been playing with you, like someone's playing games, someone is like hurting your feelings, and I think that you see through it. You know, it's kind of like that this could be you or this could be the person that you're dealing with. So you have to take it as it resonates with you. But someone is really playing and someone's hurting someone's feelings. Well, was because this is your past. Okay? So somebody was really like playing games and really didn't care about playing the games. Like they knew exactly what they were doing in the midst of them doing it. Right? And it kind of had you like looking at it like, is it an illusion? Like, am I tripping? Like, or is this person like really playing with me? You know? So that's a good thing because you woke up behind it and you seen that someone was playing with you. And so then therefore, instead of you holding on to things that is no good for you, you put your guard up basically and say that you're not standing for it, you know? So right now in your present, you are protecting yourself. You're protecting your foundation at all costs because you're like, no, like I can't just sit here and be okay with you playing with me, and I know that you're playing games. You know what I'm saying? So that caused you to make a decision. So you've made a decision that, like your emotions was involved in it. So that caused you to make a decision. Like you was acting like you didn't see it at first. And I think that was just you trying to figure out everything. You know what I'm saying? Like because you didn't see it when it first started happening to you, but now you're very aware of it. Because, like I said, life wants you to know that you are giving away your power. And you are a badass, so you need to act like it, okay? Because down at the bottom, you have the Emperor. This is your future. You have the Emperor in your future. But it's in reverse, okay? And the Emperor is someone who is really stern and know what it is that they want out of life. And everything. So basically, I feel like that you more so need to honestly like sit with yourself and see what it is that you really honestly want out of life. So you won't let that same energy keep on repeating. Like it's a lesson that you have to learn. And you have the Hangman next to that. And I more so think that the Hangman is here because, you didn't put yourself in that situation, like somebody put you in that situation, so you're not like really ready, you're not in the midst of sitting in it anymore at all. And then you have the Four of Swords right here. This is someone who puts themselves up and then like just sit back and rest and try to figure out things, but you're not in that place no more because you're like, I'm not gonna sit in it no more. And I don't need to rest on it anymore because I see it for what it really is. And that's the reason why your overall energy of the reading is cutting out things that don't serve you no farther in life. Okay? People, places, and things. That is what you're cutting out because they no longer serve you. So basically, your reading is about you not giving away your power no more because you've done it before. And you've seen how people responded and how people reacted to it, and you're not in the midst of doing that no more. So now you're like, oh no, I cannot keep on falling for that. But that's a good thing, Capricorn, because you learned your lesson. Because if you don't learn your lesson in this situation, then you will have to keep on repeating the same thing. Like, God will take you through the same thing until you learn the lesson that he was trying to teach you within the situation that you was going through, okay? So let's see. Let's see why this Five of Swords is here. Why is the Five of Swords here for Capricorn? Five of Swords for Capricorn. I don't know why my throat is so dry. This is the Capricorn. Why is the Five of Swords here for Capricorn? The Five of Swords. See, somebody was playing with you. That's what I'm saying. It could have been about money. It could be about a trip. You know what I'm saying? Just like completing phases. Like, you're just over it. You're over that. You are not no longer standing and letting people play with you because you know that you... It could be about money. It could be about, you know... This says overseas trips, but it don't have to be like an overseas trip. It could be an overseas trip. It could be that, like, if y'all was planning to go somewhere and this person kept on playing with you and, like, bagging out, and then you were super prepared for it and they wasn't prepared for it, and that could have pissed you off, because I think that you're the type of person who likes to have all of your ducks in a row because you have the Queen of Wands right here. And the Queen of Wands is someone who, you know, it's positive, outspoken. It's like, basically, you just let them play games and you didn't speak up for yourself. You wasn't like, because like I said, you got the Moon card. So basically, you was really blind to it. And then you got the Seven of Swords. This is someone who know that they're being sneaky. Like, maybe they was just trying to, you know, play with you for some reason. I don't know if it was money involved or whatever happened, but, or if they just, like, if you did something to them, and, you know, the world is evil. So somebody could have just been being evil and really just try to play with you. You know what I'm saying? But all in the same token, like I said, Capricorn, you seen it, because you was looking at it like, oh no, I'm not. Like, you seen it. You seen through their bullshit. So basically, they didn't play you, they played themselves at the end of the day. And that caused you to stand up and not accept nothing that don't serve you. You know? So let's see what a Moon card is here. What is the Moon card here for Capricorn? The Moon card for Capricorn. See what I'm saying? It was an illusion. Like, they wanted to make it seem to you like that they was paying attention, and then that, you know, it was probably a delay going on or something like that, but they wanted to make you think that they were paying attention and then that they were so serious about it. But like I said, you seen through the bullshit. They was acting like that they were so ready to go. This could be like somebody who came to you about this situation and was like, yeah, let's do it, let's go, let's go. They were all ready and probably had your hopes up as well. You know what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, it was like, okay, let me tell you what. I'm not dumb. God opened up my eyes. It was basically like, it was a decision, and you was like, okay, I'm done. Like, I tried with you, I prayed about it and everything, and you still managed to do what you wanted to do. So basically, that was like God opening up your eyes to this person, letting you see that they're not a stand-up person. Like, that's not the type of people that you want to be around. Because see, you got the Ten of Cups, and the Ten of Cups is in reverse. This means like happiness, like good things, party and celebration, and it didn't go down. So you have the Ten of Cups in reverse as well. You got the Emperor again, because you was like, oh no, I gotta find my stability. I'm not ready to sit up here and let someone keep on coming in and, you know, getting my hopes up, and then they shut me down at the end of the day. And like I said, it was because that person was probably being greedy. But you're not a greedy type, and you seen through it, okay? And you're not even so much of stressing about it at all. You know, like you're not up in your head about it. You're not playing it over and over again in your head because you knew that that person was young and they had an idea and the idea sounded okay. But at the end of the day, they don't know how to make decisions for themselves. Okay? The Ace of Swords. Lots of Ace of Swords here for Capricorn. The Ace of Swords for Capricorn. The Ace of Swords for Capricorn. The cards is just flying out. See what I'm saying? See, you got the Ace of Swords. That means that you cut off things. You don't give a damn how good it looked or none of that. It's just like, okay, listen, I'm done with you. I'm content. I'm cool. You feel what I'm saying? Like, you're like, okay, I'm just going to sit here. And I'm still going to love you. But at the end of the day, I see through your bullshit. You know what I'm saying? Because this person could be wanting something out of you. This is a new beginning. You just like, all right, I'm going on a new beginning, a new path. You know what I'm saying? He was like, yeah, you had a good idea, but it didn't fall through the way that it was supposed to fall through. So you got the Ace of Wands twice. That's like new beginnings. And, you know, or birth, new ideas, creation. So this person did have a good idea in their mind, but they didn't stick to it. So that made you be like, okay, listen, I'm about to turn it around and I'm about to start with a new beginning because you messed everything up. So basically, you're not letting nobody take control no more. You're like, this is a travel, this is like, okay, you was sitting there and you was waiting for your ships to come in, you was ready for the travel, or whatever it was that you had going on, and like I said, this person failed you, you know, you was all ready to go, and then somebody tore you down. I was just talking about a situation, like, I don't like to plan my life out, because I don't like to be disappointed at the end of the day, whenever someone don't stand up to what they said that we were gonna do. And so to prevent myself from being mad and having an attitude, then therefore don't plan nothing for me. I plan it myself. So that caused you to feel like a little unattached from this person, and you went soul searching and you went within. Okay? And like I said, if this person probably wants to come back now and like talk to you, or probably trying to deliver a message through somebody else and don't really want to come to you themselves, because for the simple fact, they know that you could have, you know, like lost things by getting yourself together. Like it could have been plans that you were making and you shut your plans down because you was all for what this person had going on, and then they ended up shutting down, and they know that you're mad about it, so now they don't even know how to come back and tell you because they feeling like that you're like really shitty at them, right? So basically what they're going to try to do is they're just going to try to work on things and just try to be like super perfect around you now, just so they can win you back over, so you won't have your guard up, because they don't want you to be mad at them. They don't want you to have your guard up on them. You know what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, if they just would have took a leap of faith, because they know that you're not a fool, okay? So basically, like, if they just would have took a leap of faith and kept it all the way real with you, and you know what I'm saying, and told you the truth about what it was that was going on, or instead of playing all the games, because what I'm saying is that they already knew what was going on before it even happened, right? They knew what was going on, but they still chose to go with it. So then, therefore, that's causing you to be looking at it like, see, people play too much. Like, people just play too much. Like, I'm not, So basically now, in your present, you got your guard up because you're protecting your foundation and everything, and they can't be mad at you because you had to make a decision to basically like cut this person off because you've seen that person's true colors and you know that they're not true to you. You know that they're not, you know, what you would expect someone to be who is around you and say that they mean well. Okay, why is the King of Swords here for Capricorn? The King of Swords for Capricorn. The King of Swords, the Capricorn, one of the King of Swords. Let's see. This could be someone that you are like in a relationship with, or you know what I'm saying? Like this could be your mate, like your significant other who pulled this bullshit, you know what I'm saying? And then it's more so of like now they want to build the relationship, you know. It could be a relative. It was just like a loving relationship, and you thought that that's what it honestly was. Whoever this person is, you just thought that it was a loving relationship, but come to find out, that's not what it was. Like, you basically got played. That person played you. But they didn't play you, they played themselves because you seen through the bullshit at the end of the day. And like I said, you was giving away your power. You are a badass, so act like it. And listen, you power back up. You're not going for it. Because now you're protecting your foundation and they're wondering why. Like, why am I getting treated this way and that way? Oh, I gotta cut off things that no longer serve me because you play with me. So then therefore, like, we're all grown. I have no time to play with anybody. So you just cut it off. Why is the Two of Swords here for Capricorn? Two of Swords for Capricorn. You most definitely took your power back, though. The Two of Swords. Okay. See what I'm saying? You didn't want to make the decision because you was trying to look at it and see if this person was really trying to play you, right? But they was, because for the simple fact, it was something in it that was like everything that glitters not gold, right? So you have to be more so careful of who you are giving energy to, who you are letting like take control, who you're letting take the upper hand. Because for the simple fact, this person, like they can have all the choices in the world, but they still might not make the right choice, which is all of us, to make everybody happy at the end of the day. So then therefore, that's why you was like, I'm not happy with this, and I'm not happy with you, so I gotta make a decision to just cut you off a little bit. And you may not have to cut that person all the way off, but all in the same token, this person brought a lot of frustration to you. You know what I'm saying? And had you feeling like that someone had control of you, like that, you know, they were just playing too much. They took you all the way to the point where you had to cut them off, where it was no other way but to cut them off. You had to cut them off, cut it short. Because, like, no, I cannot let you, like, basically, you was giving your power away. Okay? So, why is the Emperor here? The Capricorn, the Emperor. See, the Emperor is there because you was not standing up the way that you needed to be standing up. The Emperor is there because that's someone who holds firmly. Like, you have to take more initiative. Like, you have to be more so. This is the Empress. This is someone who does not play games. You know exactly what you want. This is a boss. Like, you have to step up. You know what I'm saying? Step up and take control. And I think that that's what you're doing now. I mean, this is your future. But it more so teaches you is that you take control. You don't let nobody else take control. You have to be the one who takes control of your life and what you want. You put your life and your situations and your plans in other people's hands. They can fail you at any times. But if you keep it in your own hands, then, you know, you're gonna be more satisfied with what goes on behind what you created. Or what you caused, other than somebody else, you putting everything in someone else's hands, and they the ones who cause all the bullshit. You know? The Hangman. Why is the Hangman here for Capricorn? Let's see, because you got the Knight of Pentacles. This is someone like you got the Hangman right here, and that's like you. I don't know. This is someone who puts themselves in a situation by themselves, okay? And you could have lost out. You could have lost out on a lot. And that's the reason why you have the King of Pentacles in reverse, because the King of Pentacles, like, not in reverse, that's someone who is like on their shit. You know what you want. You got all your shit together, like you have your ducks in a row. So basically, that's what I'm saying. Don't just, like let somebody else take the lead. You have to take the lead because, they didn't want to give you the good news. It was basically like they wanted to build you up to tear you down. That's how I see it. The Four of Swords in reverse for Capricorn. Why is the Four of Swords in reverse for Capricorn? See, because it's basically like you have to put yourself up. Because like if you don't sit back and think about things, which I feel like that you honestly did, I feel like that you sat back and you thought about it because you're cutting things out that no longer serve you, okay? So basically it's like you have the Two of Wands, and that's like a short journey. Like moving to like calmer waters, That's like moving to calmer waters. And you wasn't doing that at first, but if you don't get the lesson that was put out for you, top off, then this is the energy that you're gonna study be in. You're not gonna be able to know how to move to calm waters. You're not gonna be able to know how to self-soothe or to not like lash out about people doing things that you don't agree with. It's more so gonna like you're never gonna be content. It's like you're never gonna be content. I mean, you're not frustrated about the money situation at all. Like it's like you're not frustrated about that. But it's still that you have to learn the lesson in it, or you're gonna have to keep on carrying the load of someone else's bullshit, Because the devil's always lurking. And this person could just be like, jealous, or you know what I'm saying, or just like holding you back from things that they know that, how people just be jealous and then they don't want to give you all the information, or they don't want to let you get that one foot forward because they feel like that it will come back on them in some type of way. Well, more so I want to say come back on them in a certain type of way, but they feel more so of that like you would shit on them, like that you. Oh no, I can't let them get the upper hand because then therefore they're gonna leave me in a ditch. But that comes behind heartbreak. That comes from heartbreak. Like somebody is like, I don't know if you broke this person's heart before or whatever, but they're just not using their intuition. They're just young and they're just trying to step on your toes for some type of reason. I don't know why. But you just have to watch your surroundings and watch the people that you're dealing with, because people can be honestly evil in the world. But you don't let that shut you down. You just have to go through the motion, because going through the motion is basically God showing you that you have to turn to Him. You cannot turn to other people for your needs, for your wants, for your fun, for nothing. You have to turn to God. You have to go within and figure out what it is that you really want out of life. And don't let nobody else direct your path. You stay on your own path because you know what's up, Capricorn. Like you real, like you're a real individual. So you honestly know what's going on and you can see through these people's bullshit. But just make sure that you learn the lesson in it of what someone was trying to do. You have to know whenever someone is being sneaky, or like if it's genuine or if it's really not. Basically, so that's more so of what you need to start paying attention to, Capricorn. Okay, and that is your reading. Don't give away your power. You have to stand up and know whenever somebody is being a bullshitter. Okay, so that's your reading, Capricorn. I love you all so much, and you have a blessed night.